falling for you. Falling Dan. For you.
You're taking your time. Why you do me like this? You know me loving your wine. Pretty girl, you're giving me signs. And you tell me you don't want me.
Can you think I'm doing? Welcome back to my channel. It is Jodie. So today I'm going to show you guys how to create this absolutely stunning glowy skin, healthy glow look. So I tried out some new products today that I obviously reviewed in this video as well. So if you'd love to see how I created this look, stay tuned and keep on watching. So guys, we are going to start off with my skin. Now everyone should know by now that I have oily skin. If you don't, I'm an oily gal. So I tend to use my two primers, which is the Fenty Beauty Pore Filtered Matte Primer, and then I go in with the Baby Skin Pore Eraser Primer by Maybelline. So I'm just gonna mix these and put them on my skin as usual. So I got a few new products that I'm actually going to try out. I'm actually quite excited about them because they are the Havana Camila Cabello collection. So I got them from Pretty Little Thing, and I'm just going to try a few of these things today. So I only got like three products anyway, because you know you're never sure. I was like, but one of them I got is the Havana Camila Cabello eyeshadow in Control. First of all, I'm going to go in with my Morphe 39A palette, and I'm just going to literally do something really, really quick and simple for you guys today, because I just wanted to start these products. So I'm going to go in with one of my fluffy brushes, and this is by Fian. So I got this, I think, off Amazon as a collection, and these brushes are so lovely. But yeah. So I'm going to take the I'm going to take this shade here actually first. So that really nice orange shade. I love this colour, because this palette you can literally use all the shades. Okay, now that my lid is basically prepped and set, I'm gonna actually go in with that Havana Camila Cabello collection, and I'm gonna just take that shade, if I can open it up. I'm just gonna swipe some on my finger. And just see how this looks. Oh, it's quite like pinky. It's very pinky. And I'm gonna dab it onto my lid and see how it comes out without a brush first. It's pretty not as powerful as I thought. I thought it was gonna come out really vibrant, but it's not. It probably would come out better with a brush and like maybe setting spray. Okay, another new item, or new items that I picked up, were the Makeup Revolution Crushed Pearl Pigments. So I got three of them. I got Sass Queen, DTF, and Beck and Cool. I think I'm gonna go in with DTF. I'm just gonna see how these come out on top of this. So I'm doing like a little sip bit. So I presume you could just pop that little bit in the lid. What I'm going to do now, I'm gonna put them on top of the shade that I've just put on my lid now. I'm gonna go in with that and just see how that comes out. I'm hoping it comes out. Oh, honey. This has come out real pretty. Okay, so I'm actually going to take the palette that I used to the mirror for. I'm going to take the Huda Beauty Warm Obsessions palette, and I'm just going to go in with that really nice berry tone, because I feel like we're going pinkish now. So I'm going to take that berry tone right there, and again I'm just going to use that same brush that I always use. I'm going to dab off the excess, and I'm going to be going in the inner corner and outer corners of my lids. I'm going to dab here and sweep.
Falling for you.
Okay, so my lids are pretty much done. It's kind of turned into a little bit of a halo, but we're just gonna go with this. What I'm actually gonna do is go on the bottom of my lash line, and I'm gonna be using that really deep berry tone there in that Huda Beauty Warm Sessions palette. And I am gonna take this really fluffy brush, and I'm gonna go on the bottom of my line. So you look like a punching bag right now, but what you need to do is grab yourself one of your makeup remover wipes, or if you've got like a micellar water lotion, and just put it on cotton wool. And I'm just gonna clean this up now.
Pretty girl, you're giving me signs, then you tell me you don't want me, can you make up your mind? Pretty girl, you're taking your time, why you do me like this, you know me?
I'm actually going to do as well, because I'm going to take another kind of buffing brush. I'm going to take the Carmela Cabello eyeshadow. I'm actually going to sweep on the bottom of my lash line. I'm going to see how it looks.
Me loving your wine. Pretty girl, you're giving me signs, and you tell me you don't want me, can you make up your mind?
Oh, okay. All it did is it just softened that purple up, and I quite like it like that actually. Okay guys, so my lashes are on, eyes are done. So I'm obviously holding the product that I'm gonna show you next. So I'm gonna go in with the Sunlit Bronzer / Medium to Dark Skin by Havana Camilla Cabello. So this says it's meant to be hydrating, lightweight, and ultra blendable. So you can use it alone or mix it with your foundation for an instant Havana Sunlit Glow. So I'm actually going to put it on my skin first, and then just put a few drops of my NYX Total Drop Foundation and blend it all together. Let's just go like that. Obviously, I don't really know how much to use, but so I'm gonna use my always loved Point XL Real Techniques brush, and I use this for my foundation stuff. Oops. Foundation and things like that. I absolutely love this brush. Where is nice, and it's not like heavy. Okay, so the next thing I'm going to take is my Total Drop foundation by NYX, and this is in the shade Mocha. So I'm gonna put a tiny few drops of this. I absolutely love this foundation. It's so flawless. It like makes your skin look so good, and I'm like running out. I'm gonna take that same brush and just buff that into my skin. I was saying in my other video that this is the only foundation that actually matches my skin perfectly. Like, it just matches so bloody well. Oh, so good. Next item I'm gonna take is my Black Opal Stick Foundation in the shade Nutmeg, and I'm gonna use this to conceal under my eyes, my forehead, and my chin. I love this product. But I hope you don't drown. Better be careful what you say out of your mouth. You know it ain't never safe when I'm around. They say bad girls never do no good, good. Got it all. Okay, so I'm gonna take my beauty blender that is damp, and I'm just gonna blend that out quickly. Guys, my stomach is growling because I'm so hungry right now. I need to finish this and go eat. So I'm gonna set my face with the Fit Me Maybelline Matte and Poreless Pressed Powder in Caramel. I love this stuff, and as I said, I'm waiting for the other powders to arrive so that I can see how they are, because I've heard so much good things about them. Okay, so while that is setting on my face, I'm actually going to try something new today that I ordered, and I've been so excited for it to arrive. It is the CoverGirl Queen Collection Ebony Bronzer. Now, black women, I'm sorry, but this shade... I'm just going to take my brush and just dab a little bit, because obviously this looks super pigmented. I'm so excited to see what this looks like. Dab a little bit.
I'm sorry.
look super bronzed and just so I'm gonna get my NYX first and I'm just gonna wipe off the excess powders and I'm just gonna mix them together. So that's the worst thing, looking like you just plonked on powders onto your face. Okay, so I'm gonna go in with my Juvia's Place Saharan Blush Volume 1 palette, and I'm actually gonna take that really vibrant fuchsia pink palette color. Sorry, I'm just gonna dab a tiny bit and dab off any excess because I don't want this to come out super bright, but you just wanna peach out your cheeks, peach them up, you know, put some color into your skin. As you can see, it's already super pigmented and probably too pigmented for me, to the point where I'm rosy. I'm actually gonna set my face with the Slay All Day Gérard Cosmetics in the scent Rose, just before we move on. Okay, so I'm actually gonna take the Havana Camilla Cabello bronzer, or sunlit bronzer, and I'm actually gonna use a tiny bit on my skin. Here. And then I think I'm just gonna like move it around my face and see how this looks. So I think I'm gonna probably put like a highlight on top of that just to make it pop. So I'm gonna take the Three Step to Sculpt palette in the shade Deep, and I'm gonna take that really, really nice clear or highlighter. That one there. I think that gives it a little bit more zhuzh. So another one of the new items that I got were the Makeup Revolution Renaissance lip liners. And so I actually got three shades. I got Chauffeur, Greatest, and Takeover. I'm just thinking what lip I kind of want to do. I'm going to use Takeover today. I'm just going to draw on my lips. This colour isn't what I expected it to actually be. That part actually wasn't recording. I'm super annoyed. I'm going in with the Loreal Ultra Matte Liquid Lipstick in Box of Chocolates. That's what I kind of used. Okay, so I am going to go in with the Havana Camilla Cabello collection. I'm going to take the lip gloss lip dew. I'm just going to go over my lips with that on this shade. Oh, this smells amazing. And this is like a brown shade, so it should warm up that pale colour on my lips. Okay guys, so this is the finished look. I literally love it. I look super bronzed, super glowy. Like, the products were just phenomenal. My main, obviously, favorite products that I got new were the Sunlit Bronzer, the Lip Gloss. The single eyeshadow, I just didn't feel like it was pigmented enough, so it just wasn't really doing it for me that well. Absolutely love the Makeup Revolution crushed pearl pigments. This is literally pigmented and it's absolutely stunning on the lids. I cannot wait to try the other two. So yes, I should be using those as well very, very soon in a tutorial. So super excited for that. Can we just take a moment to appreciate the CoverGirl Queen Ebony Bronzer? This is beautiful. I think I look super healthy. My skin looks super bronzed, like it literally does what it said. And again, for £11 from Amazon, you really can't go wrong. Yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed doing it with me. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope to see you in my next tutorial. And yeah, if you recreate this look, do not forget to tag me in it on my Instagram. My Instagram is jodie_vidal. Make sure you go follow me on there as well if you aren't already. But yeah, hopefully I will see you in my next one, guys. And I really hope you enjoyed this. Do not forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you in my next one. Cry me a river, but I hope you don't drown. Better be careful what you say out of your mouth. You know it ain't never safe when I'm around.